tonight, I am not going to engage in any kind of criticism. Instead, I intend to propose a new concept of existence. And I shall be as abstract as this intention forces me to be. You can find the essay, the complete exposition, in some chapters of my Brief England Existence, and naturally in my last book, Logic of the Worlds, which is out in French, will be published in English at the end of the next year, I hope. As all of you know perfectly well, the fundamental problem is to distinguish, on the one hand, being as such, being qua being, and on the other hand, existence, as a category which precisely is not reducible to that of being. It's the heart of the matter, and it's also the difficulty. This difference between being and existence is the result of the consideration of spatial type of being is the most general solution of the problem. It's a case for Heidegger, with the distinction between Sein and Dasein. If we take into account the etymological framework, we can see that existence, which depends on Dasein, is something like a topological concept. It's to be here, to be in the world. And in fact, I also shall propose to determine the very general concept of existence by the necessity of thinking the place or the world of everything which is. And this place is not deducible from being as such. But clearly for Heidegger, Dasein and finally existence is a name for human being, for historical destiny of thinking, for crucial and creative experience of the becoming of being itself. I shall propose the concept of being here and of existence without any reference to something like consciousness, experience of human being. A pure rational concept of the slight distance between a multiplicity and the same multiplicity here in its place, in the world. If now we examine the work of Sartre, we can see that the distance between being and existence is a dialectical consequence of the difference between being and nothingness. In fact, existence is the effect of nothingness within the full and stupid massiveness of being qua being. This effect is absolutely the free subject in whom existence precedes essence. I shall also propose tonight to determine the concept of existence under the condition of something like negation. Ontologically, it's for me the question of the void, the question of the empty set. Logically, it's the question of negation in its intuitionistic sense. But all that will have no relationship with something like a subject, and even less with freedom. You will certainly notice that I am taking something from Kant, precisely that existence is something like a degree or an intensity of being there, of being in the world. This idea we can find the famous passage of the first critic concerning the anticipations of perception. And I am taking something from here, namely that existence has to be sought as a movement from pure being to being that, or from essence to ferment, or appearing, or seeing, as Hegel explains in two obscure profound chapters of his logics. But I am attempting to do the same thing without the transcendental subject and without the becoming of the absolute idea. My proposal will be in three parts. First, a short ontological part. What is our concept of being qua being? The answer will be multiplicity. Second, what is our concept of the localization of something which is? What is being that? The answer will be the transcendental field without subject. Third, what is existence? The answer will be the degree of something's identity to itself in a world. Is its existence in this world. What is a thing? Another famous essay of Heidegger's. What is a thing has something which is, but which is without any determination of its being, except it's precisely being as such. We can speak of an object of the world. We can distinguish it in the world by its properties or predicates. In fact, we can experience the complex network of identities and differences by which this object is clearly not identical to another object of the same world. But a thing is not an object. A thing is not yet an object. Like the hero of the Greek novel by Robert Musil, a thing is something without qualities. We must think of the thing before its objectivation in a precise word. The thing is das Ding, maybe das Urding. That is this form of being, which certainly is after the indifference of nothingness, but also before the qualitative difference of objects. We must formalize the concept of thing just between, on the one hand, the absolute purity of nothingness, and on the other hand, the complexity of objects. A thing is always the pure pre-objective basis of objectivity. And it's the reason for which a thing is nothing other than a multiplicity. Not a multiplicity of objects, not a system of quality, a network of differences, but a multiplicity of multiplicities. And a multiplicity of multiplicities of multiplicities. And so on. Is there an end to that sort of dissemination, to speak in Jack Derrida? Yes, there is an end point, but this end point is not a primitive object or an atomic component. It's not the form of the one. The end point is of necessity also a multiplicity. The multiplicity which is the multiplicity of no multiplicity at all. The thing which is also no thing. The void. The empty multiplicity. If a thing is between indifference and difference, nothingness and objectivity, it's because a pure multiplicity is composed of the form. The multiple as such has to do with difference and pre-objectivity. The void has to do with indifference and complete lack of object. From the work of Cantor at the end of the 19th century, we know that it's completely rational to propose that sort of construction of pure multiplicity from the void as a framework for mathematics. It's why I have written that if ontology is the science of the thing, the pure something, we must conclude that ontology is mathematics. The theory is formalism, as I said. The elements of the set are sets, and the point of departure of the world construction is precisely the antecedent. That is for the ontological part. Our question now is to understand the birth of objectivity. How can a pure multiplicity, a set, appear in a world, in a very complex network of differences, identities, qualities, intensities, and so on? It's impossible to deduce something like that form of purely mathematical thinking of the multiplicity as a set of sets, ultimately composed of the purity of the form. If ontology is mathematics, phenomenology as a theory of appearing and objectivity concerns relationship between qualitative differences, problems of identity and of existence. And all that is on the basis of a place for appearance or for being there, the place we call the world. After the mathematics of being, we have to develop the logic of the